Surface roughness is an important parameter when it comes to certain aspects, say for example the piston of a vehicle or a drilled hole of the core body of an aircraft. So these are such incidents where the surface roughness is of very high importance. First on the main supply and then on the machine by holding it for 2 seconds, and then on the PC and wait for the machine to warm up. Once the computer is on, then click on this one. This is the software. And also on this XZ axis, so that the joystick will move X or Z direction. And you see here, this is X direction, the probe is moving on the X direction, and this is the backward X direction, and this is up. You can see the probe is moving up, and here the probe is moving down. So this action to be performed, this X and Z axis should be on. In case if you off it and then if you move the joystick right either in X or Z direction, see, the probe will not move, right? You see here, the probe will not move. So in order to this probe to move right in X direction or Z direction, you need to on this X Z axis. Okay, now it will move. What you see here is how to increase or decrease the speed of movement of the probe. So there you can see there's a black knob where max and min is written. So when you turn the knob towards the min side, the speed would be decreased and it would be minimum. And when you turn the knob to the max side, the speed of the probe would be increased and it will travel in high speed. So this is the sample which we are going to perform the experiment. This tip is going to measure the surface roughness of the holes. Alright. So these are the holes. They are numbered. Right. So near to the number 1, you can see the tip through it. Right. Through this, you can now observe the tip. Right. So this is the tip. So now we should move it very precisely to the center. How we will do that? By adjusting this joystick on X and Z direction. Okay. So now you can see the tip is inside the hole. Alright. So from there, you can see the tip is inside the hole and it's almost at the center. Alright. And then we will move it to touch the bottom. Okay. So when it comes precise near to the bottom, we will observe through this meter the light, the zero adjustment. Okay. So there you can see the green light, it's moving up towards the zero, which means the distance between the probe, the tip and the workpieces keep on decreasing until it reaches zero. We will move it. Now it's on zero, which means it's about to touch. There could be 2 observations made when you move the probe to just touch the surface. In the machine, the green light will travel towards the zero, and in the software, in the PC, the red color will travel towards the zero and will stay
at the zero when the probe just touched the surface of the hole.
Then we will go to measurement and then measure.
Once you press measure, you can have four observations. Top left corner, in the machine the green light will travel up and down, which means the probe is moving. Distance between the probe and surface is varying, so that's what indicated by the green light. And in the meter, in top right corner, you can see it will travel for a kind of 2 to 4 millimeters, which means that it is indicating the travel of the probe. And in the bottom left corner, you can see the light which is used to on X and Y axis of the joystick, it will be switched off, which means you can't do any manual process while the probe is on working mode. And in the right bottom corner, you can see the probe arrow that is making a kind of movement or drawing. So there you can see how the probe is moving, right? So these four observations can be made while the probe is on action. Here the close-up view of the movement of the probe is shown in side view and in front view. You can see that one. Once you press the measure, the probe will retract and go up, then travel forward, and then it will travel on the surface, and at last it will give you the graph of the roughness of the surface.
So your probe would move and the movement is shown here, right? So going over the sides, and then you will obtain a graph, right? So if I take the example of this graph, right, this region there's a deep slope, right? This means the tip, the probe tip has come out of the sample, right? So you can see that incident, right? So you see here, right, can you able to see the tip? You can see here, right? It's outside the sample. So in such incident, you will get a slope like this at the end, okay, like this. Otherwise it will go something like this. And this slope can be occurred by two reasons. Either the sample placed in a kind of slant, right, little bit slant, or there could be some slant in the hole, right, the hole may not be flat. If the hole is flat, the graph will go something like this, right? If it is coming like this, which means the sample which is placed over here, this may not be straight to the probe, that may be inclined to some angle like this or this, okay? Or else the second reason could be the hole, right? The hole which is right over here, right, that may not be flat, so that may have some inclination. So under such two situations, you will obtain a graph like this.
Then we will go to file, save as. So here is my folder. So here I will give a name. So some name. And I will save it.
While doing tests, there are some errors possible. One is measurement was aborted due to overrange message will be popped up in the screen, which means when the surface roughness probe is traveling, the distance for which is not enough to measure the surface. So say for example, the default given is 4 millimeter to travel to calculate the roughness. And if the surface is only lengthy enough for maybe 2 millimeter, then that distance is not enough for the probe to measure the surface roughness. In such case, measurement was aborted due to overrange message will be popped up. In such situation, you will press OK and automatically it will ask whether to redirect the probe. Perform auto return. So if you press yes, then the probe would be traveled back to its original position where it was already there. In such case, you will adjust the probe or give some more distance to travel in order to get a reading. Next one is accidental touch error occurred, which means while you are moving the probe to the center or upwards or downwards, if it hardly touches any surface, this message will pop up, which means it accidentally touched some surface. In such case also, you will give OK and will give redirect permission to the probe, and that will travel back to its original position. And the third one is the detector protection error occurred. This means if the tip get into a trough or a groove, this message would pop up, which means the tip or the detector is encountered a kind of surface which cannot be measured. In this case, the exit light, which is allowing the joystick to move, would be automatically turned off. So you need to manually remove that obstacle to adjust the surface, and then manually you need to press or exit light in order to probe to move. Under the situations of accidental touch error and detector protection error, a beep sound could be heard from the machine. So under such situation, you will press the stop, which is near to the joystick, to stop the sound, and you will manually look into the error. This is how we use the surface roughness tester to measure the roughness of a surface.